Friends, so today I will teach you a very very important topic, which is effective study techniques. Now this will help not only for CAT aspirants but also for any exam aspirants, you know, CA, IIT JEE, UPSC or even class 10, 12, whatever, because it is pertaining to how one should study. What are the right methods of studying? I have tried my best to make this as practical as possible, putting in with as many practical examples, researching across various students of mine over a period of time and getting their flaws, getting their negative practices and so on. So I hope you will like this endeavor, and more importantly you will put into practice, so that we as a nation, maybe that's a far-fetched thought, but yeah, why not? We as a nation would probably thrive to be the excellence in its own. So let's start the effective study techniques. The first technique or first thing which I think is very important is planning. Let's say you want to take CAT exam. Today is February, for example, and you know that exam is in October. So first of all, before starting anything, you must put in the entire plan in place. What are the various sections, what are the various subsections, how to score marks in them, what is to be studied under each and every subsection, and make a plan which is called as long-term plan. For example, by October I should be able to get this much percentile in this section and so on. So for getting that, what all needs to be done, that is called as long-term planning. Now second part of planning is medium-term plan. So you need to break it up, you know, it is very good to make long-term plan, but you need to put in piece by piece, then only the work will happen. So make a medium-term plan, say by June I should be able to cover my concepts. Then my test series would begin, and based on the mock scores I am getting, you know, the feedback which I am getting, the things will go forward. Then comes the most important thing, which is called as daily plan. So I have seen so many students who say that I have to study today for 2 hours. And what do? They study for 2 hours, they are in front of the books for 2 hours, but the productivity is probably, you know, 15-20 minutes, which happens across so many people. So just in front of the books, just to count 2 hours is not enough, please understand. So here what I have probably researched is that instead of making a daily plan in terms of timing, please make it in terms of quantity. So what is it? Make a daily plan that today I will study, let's say, 3 chapters of maths, these 20 words of vocabulary, and let's say 1 RC, and let's say 1 puzzle solving. So this is your plan, daily plan, when you have made in the early morning, in terms of quantity. Now it might take 2 hours, it might take 3 hours, it might take 2.5 hours, whatever, that doesn't matter, because you have made the plan in terms of quantity. Okay, I'll give you this very small example. Let's say I want to do a construction at my home, and there is a carpenter who will come. So he charges either 100 rupees per hour or he charges 200 rupees for making the chair which I am supposed to, you know, get it made from him. So I have 2 options, either I give him 100 rupees per hour or I give him 200 rupees and then he'll finish the work at whatever he wants. Now if I give him 100 rupees per hour, you know what, he will try to make the chair as slow as possible. And what he'll say that I don't want to compromise on quality, so I will do slow. But his main motive is no points for guessing, but to make money. But if I give him 200 rupees for the entire work, not only I am free, however time he take, but also with experience I have seen the quality of the work would be better. Because he'll say that, you know, I have to get 200 rupees, so let me do it faster, let me do it with better pace. As it is, the construction quality would be better because he will be wanting more work from me later, so he will not do, you know, that kind of thing. So I have seen that if when you give the quantity planning, you actually do as per what is to be done, and also your pace would be better. That I have seen with research and experience as well. So this is first point. The second point I would like to say is you must study in blocks of time. Please understand. Don't study at a stretch 3 hours. You must study in blocks of time. Keep these blocks as small, probably around 40 minutes or let's say 35 minutes, 45 minutes and so on. Because our mind has capacity of not stretching beyond this to be that much of productive level. So keep that block of 40 minutes, that is one. Keep that block small. Secondly, please close or switch off all sort of communication. Mobile phones, Facebook, Twitter, etc. Don't keep them in silent mode, you know. Switch off, just switch them off. I have seen, my dear friends, I have seen with so many students, they keep the mobile phone on silent, but they keep it nearby. So when they are sitting, the phone blinks. Archana calling. Archana calling. Archana calling. And you know, the blink actually gels with our heartbeat. And after 5-6 call, we take the call. And the moment we take the call, the next 2 hours are devoted to Archana. I mean, I am just using a hypothetical name. I don't know if any Archana is watching here. That doesn't matter. So the point is, just switch them off. Keep them far apart. Mobile phones, Twitter, Facebook, and so on. That is very, very important. The third point in this is you should take small break after 40 minutes. Take a break of 5 to 10 minutes. Don't take beyond it. You know, I have given this effective study techniques seminar in various colleges, in my batches and everything. And students follow it. But they interchange the timings. They study for 5 minutes and then there is a break of 45 minutes. And in the mind they are like, Gaurav sir said that we should have a small block and we should have a break. Please understand in totality, 40 to 45 minutes of study time, 5 to 10 minutes of break. So during break, what you should do? Check your mobile phone, check if there is any missed call or missed messages or whatever, and reply to them if you feel there is a need. Otherwise, you can always procrastinate when your entire study time is over. Drink water, you can listen to your favorite song, you know, one of your favorite songs. You know, relaxation, just 5 to 10 minutes, not beyond it. So that is second point. The third point I have come across, my dear friends, I have made in this presentation is avoid rounding off. Very practical, very important. Oh my God, I have seen so many students, when I say rounding off, it is both date-wise and time-wise. Let's say today is 27th of February. Today I have got the realization that I want to study. So what I do? I say, okay, fine. Let first come. It's just 2-3 days, you know. Let first come. First say I will become, you know, an amazing human. Something like that. Some things come to the mind like that. So we are rounding off. So first comes, probably we are sincere, we are not, doesn't matter. 3-4 days we are, then again we are not. And then again we make the next deadline or the next date, 15th, middle of the month. You know, starting is not good. Let's take middle this time. And then the process, the cycle continues for so many times. The same funda, my dear friend, is for time-wise rounding. Let's say it is 4:40 and I want to study. Then what do I think? Let's start at exact 5 p.m. 20 minutes, you know, let me watch TV. And if I have started TV, there is a movie coming of Amitabh Bachchan, probably I am liking it very much. Time is just flying away. And if it is 5:10 or 5:15, then I realize, oh shit, I was supposed to start at 5. Then I make a new deadline, 5:30. Let's make it round figure. And the process continues because discipline is not there. And we are in the process of rounding off every time. So what is the learning? Forget rounding off. Start the moment you want to start. As it is, it's a 40 minute cycle and then break and so on and on. You can do whatever. Fine. The fourth topic I think is you must study the tough topic, you know, when you are in your best state of mind. Please understand. Some people start, they are very weak in math. So some people start geometry or algebra. They don't like it and they do it in the night. And what do? They sleep on bed with the geometry book open. come on, yaar. And then they say that I am not able to get it. It's so tough. There are so many theorems. See, you must put in your best effort when you are in the freshest state of mind. Then probably you are actually trying to learn. Otherwise, you are just passing time or wasting time and probably blaming the circumstances or whatever. So the best is, best time is different for different people. Of course, you have to find your own best time. I have seen all kind of students. Some students are very good when they are early morning, you know, at 5 a.m. in the morning, and there is so much of peace everywhere. If you can do that, nothing like it. Some students are very good in late night, after 12 or 12:30 or something like that. So it depends. The body cycle can be adjusted for different people. You need to find out when is your most fresh time of the day. Do tough topic at that time. Find your own fresh time, and the most important part is stretch yourself during this period. If you have found out with experience that, you know, 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. is your best period, best time, then please understand, don't waste that time. That time you must stretch, postpone other activities and try to stretch during this time to your toughest topic or areas which you want to improve upon. This is point number 4. Point number 5, I have put in same more or less as point number 4, which is never study on bed, especially late nights. I have seen so many times people get sleep. You are actually inviting the sleep there. And once you get sleep in the early morning, you get up and then you are searching for book. Where is the book? Where is the book? And then you get the book. So what I actually suggest, you know, some people might find it impractical, but I have researched on various people and I have tried on my own as well. It might be a little far-fetched, but what I feel is, if you really want to sleep, if you really want to study, I'm sorry, at night, you must sit on chair table, number one. Number two, please don't wear loose clothes. I have seen it. If you are wearing formal clothes, the chances, the likelihood of you not getting sleep are far higher than if you are wearing some night clothes, you know. And let's look at point number 6. Which is keep revising, the importance of revision. You know what? Research says that we lose around 70% in just a day and around 95% within a week's time if we do not revise what we learn. So I sincerely request to each and every student to understand the importance of revision. Whatever you are learning new, please revise it in the next 24 hours for sure. And then go forward. You might study 2 or 3 hours every day, but make sure 10 to 15 minutes or maybe 20 minutes should be spent in revising what we did yesterday. That's very, very important. So what probably you can do is, you can make some associative techniques, you can use some short names, you can make a chart, bullet points on a chart board, on a cardboard, and you can put it on the wall, you can do whatever. There are so many things which can be done. But the importance of revision must be kept in mind. That is point number 6. Point number 7, effective study technique, point number 7, I think you must study in groups. You must make study groups. It's very, very important. Of course, you have to make sure that the entire group has same objective as yours. That's very important. You should have a coherent group. You must not have a group where people are pessimist. Otherwise, they will stop themselves as it is. They will stop you as well. They will always give you negative talks. They will always say that, you know, CAT, there are 2 lakh people appearing. In CA, there are just 2% of result. What we 3 guys can do? Let's go and chill and watch Dedishki of Madhuri Dixit. What are we doing here? You know, all these kind of things. And when all these things come up, we ourselves as human beings are very prone to all these temptations. The moment something like this come up, it is very tough to stop. So you must ensure that you have a good coherent group wherein each one of you is helping each other. That is another advantage of group study, teaching each other. So once you teach your friend, if he is weak in some area, you get taught by some other friend who is strong in some other area. Once you teach each other, you are also revising. Please understand that very topic. It helps you in revision as well. So make a good study group. Eighth point, I think, is the point, because I'm in this line, you might feel. The eighth point is choose a right mentor. Choose a right guru. You must have a very important coach or a trainer or a teacher so that he can or he or she can show you the guiding light. He can inspire you in your process of preparation. It's very important. If you are not that fortunate to have a teacher in your proximity, you can always have your online guru kind of a thing. You can always look up to someone. Probably me. Of course, my pleasure. But the point is, if you remember, Eklavya also had the guru in the form of Dronacharya, without Dronacharya even knowing about it. Read mythology. Later on, Dronacharya asked for Eklavya's thumb as a guru dakshina, is a different story altogether. But the point remains, Eklavya learnt in so much by making the idol of Dronacharya and keep on practicing, and he learned so very much, and he dedicated his entire learning to guru. So you must choose a right mentor, you must look up to him, you must get inspired by the thoughts which will act as fuel in your preparation. Please understand. Point number 9, please don't neglect it. Some people neglect it very much. It is healthy body. If you are preparing consistently for an exam, let's say CAT, let's say IIT JEE, which is a long-term 2-year preparation, let's say UPSC, which is, I mean, infinite time preparation, you never know which year you will clear pre, which year you will clear main, and which year you will clear for interview, and if at all you might not clear anything. It's such a long, consistent preparation and such a belief kind of an exam. So in that, you need to keep your body healthy. See, diseases are, they might come anytime. We can't stop. But at least we can take care to some extent by not inviting them. So we must take our actions for keeping our body healthy. So what are they? First, I think you should always have breakfast. Please don't skip breakfast at any cost. Why only breakfast? See, it is a scientific reason. When we sleep 8 hours in the night, the entire metabolic functions, the body does, the brain does, the mind does, everything. You know, the entire energy is taken from the body. So when we get up, the body needs to be replenished as soon as possible. That's the scientific reason. You must have a very healthy breakfast, for sure. Second point is, you must have milk at least once a day in your preparation phase. Some people don't like milk. You know, I sincerely request, take it as a medicine. If you are preparing for a competitive exam, you want to be consistent, the kind of motivation and everything, milk is very helpful thing. It not only helps in entire body thing as a science, but let me tell you, it also helps in memory building. That's the most important advantage of milk. Then you must keep low profile in dinner. Some students I have seen, you know, they go out for dinners because most of the people are working or their friends are working. So they get to spend time in dinner, and when they go out, they just, you know, it's like I have seen so many people as if they are letting out their entire frustration on food. You know, I'll just rip apart this hotel today. I mean, come on. So please keep low profile on dinner, because once you do that, the entire metabolic function gets destroyed. Most important point, you must eat lots of salad and fruits. You know, they give you a lot of energy and they give a feel-good factor as well, keeping the body functions, of course. And of course, you must do exercise. Every day, half an hour a day, you must exercise. Either take a sport, physical sport, or you can hit the gym as well. But the idea is to sweat. The idea is to get sweat from the body. So that is very important. Point number 10. After healthy body comes healthy mind. What are you guys doing to keep your mind healthy? Anyone? I have seen so many students, they just do nothing for mind. For body, some people do sometimes some things. But for mind, hardly anyone does anything. So what is to be done? Solve puzzles, solve Sudoku, solve crossword. You know, these are the things which act as fuel for mind. make a discipline thing in your life system today itself, that at least once a week, 1 hour, say Sunday, you will solve crossword puzzles, you will solve Sudoku puzzles, you will solve Kakaru puzzles, you will solve lots of lateral thinking puzzles, or you know, some analytical puzzles, so that your mind will improve, you can enhance thinking, you can think in various directions, out of the box thinking we call it. All these things are ultimately mind related. See, don't think that if you solve puzzle, that particular puzzle question will not come in your exam. It is never like that. You take any exam, most of the time, once your concepts are over, it is all applications. So you will be able to apply only when your horizon of mind is enhanced. You know, your thinking ability is enhanced. And then you can apply the concepts in a much better manner. Fine. 11th point I would like to put, my dear friends, as enjoy preparation. It's very important. Whatever you are doing, don't take it as a burden on your head. Once we enjoy something, the output is better. I'm sure you'll agree with me. Sometimes it happens that we are not able to study, let's say after 12 in the night or 12:30 in the night or something like that. You know, the sleep is inviting us and we sleep. But most of the time, you, the same person, will probably agree to me that when your girlfriend is near you, she has come from other town, and you are able to spend only some few hours in the night time or whatever, you know, you will say with you the time, I am not able to understand how the time has flown. It is 4 in the morning. I mean, where the time has gone? So what is the real reason? The real reason is that you are enjoying that time, and once you are enjoying, you will not know how much time has actually elapsed. So please understand. And how to enjoy? See, the point is motivation. You must always realize that you are doing for the betterment in the future of career or whatever. So that motivation should constantly, you know, be at the back of your mind. And you must understand that this preparation phase, you have to enjoy. Then only the output will be better, then only the results will be better, then only you will be performing at the best of your potential. Fine. The last point, point number 12, is, I am no one to say, it is said by the Sri, great Sri Swami Vivekananda, no points for guessing, this is believe in yourself. Swami Vivekananda said that, believe in yourself and the world will be at your feet. His famous lecture at USA, if you can go, if you can get it on YouTube or whatever. Believing in yourself is the most important thing for any long-term exam. You must always have positive thoughts. Please cultivate positive thoughts, because thoughts will lead to actions, and action will finally give you the belief. So belief is the most important thing, thought is the most important thing. You must think positive every time. Never think like a loser. There are so many students giving, what will happen to me, or something like that. You must always feel that there are, let's say, 200 seats in IIM Ahmedabad. I just need one. The entire approach is changed by just one thought process. Some people think, say that there are 2 lakh people and 200 seats, every 1,000 there is one or whatever. Mera kya hoga, something like that. That is one way of looking at it. The moment I see, I just need one seat, there are 200 available, still there are 200 times available than what I need. Where is the competition? I am just telling you a thought process which will ignite another kind of, you know, belief system in you. So I think that's all for the day as far as effective study technique is concerned. I would love to receive your feedback, your you know, any suggestions or anything, and more importantly, what you have incorporated, the ideas that you have probably garnered from this session. Thank you, friends.